Good morning, and a very warm welcome to you all. Let's begin today's service with the singing of hymn number 254. And if you can't hear me, please raise your hand and I will talk louder. Yeah, it's true. The words of this hymn are by the discoverer and founder of Christian Science, Mary Baker Eddy. O'er waiting harp strings of the mind, there sweeps a strain, low, sad and sweet, whose measures bind the power of pain, and wake a white-winged angel throng with thoughts illumed by faith and breathed in raptured song with love perfumed. Then his unveiled sweet mercies show life's burdens light. I kiss the cross and wake to know a world more bright. And o'er earth's troubled, angry sea, I see Christ walk and come to me and tenderly, divinely talk. Thus truth engrounds me on the rock upon life's shore, gainst which the winds and waves can shock, oh, nevermore. From tired joy and grief afar, and nearer thee. Father, where thine own children are, I love to be. My prayer, some daily good to do to thine for thee, an offering pure of love, whereto God leadeth me. Hymn number 254. The scriptural selection is from Romans and Nehemiah. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. All the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Ezra the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel. And Ezra the priest brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women, and all that could hear with understanding, upon the first day of the seventh month. And he read therein before the street that was before the water gate, from the morning until midday, before the men and the women, and those who could understand. And the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law. And Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God. So they read in the book, in the law of God, distinctly, and gave the sense, and caused them to understand the readings. And Nehemiah said unto all the people, This day is holy unto the Lord your God. Then he said unto them, Go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom there is nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. And all the people went their way to eat and to drink, and to send portions, and to make great mirth, because they had understood the words that were declared unto them. Let's have a few moments of silent prayer, and then pray together the Lord's Prayer, and I shall follow with its spiritual interpretation as given in Science and Health.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Our Father, Mother, God, all harmonious.
Hallowed be thy name.
Adorable One.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom is come. Thou art ever present.
Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Enable us to know, as in heaven, so on earth, God is omnipotent, supreme.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us grace for today. Feed the famished affections.
And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors.
And love is reflected in love.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And God leadeth us not into temptation, but delivereth us from sin, disease, and death.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
For God is infinite, all power, all life, truth, love, over all, and all. Let's unite in singing hymn number 267. Our God is all in all. His children cannot fear. See baseless evil fall, and know that God is here. Hymn number 267. Is extended to all of you. Thank you for being here. This church is a branch of the Mother Church, the first church of Christ Scientists in Boston, Massachusetts, a church designed in the words of its founder, Mary Baker Eddy, to commemorate the word and works of our Master, which should reinstate primitive Christianity and its lost element of healing. The Bible lesson sermon read here is also read throughout the world today. A Sunday school for children and teenagers meets every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. Students are taught the scriptures and the healing truths of Christian Science and their use in daily life. This church also provides a free public reading room as a loving outreach to our community. It is a quiet sanctuary for prayer and study of the Bible and Christian Science literature, which you can read, borrow, or purchase. The reading room is open for a half hour prior to each Wednesday meeting and for a half hour after each Sunday service. Every Wednesday evening, we hold a testimony meeting. After readings from the Bible and from the Christian Science textbook, the congregation is invited to share personal experiences and healings that have come from the study and application of Christian Science. Please join us. The meeting begins at 8 p.m. and all are welcome. The members of this church are reminded about a special meeting that will be held Friday at 8 p.m. Information about the Zoom contact will be sent to you. We invite you to attend our services, use the reading room, and bring your children to Sunday school.
Make you to shine. like the sun and hold you in the palm of my hand. The snares of the fowler will never capture you, and a famine will bring you no fear. Under God's wings, your refuge, with faithfulness, your shield, and I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of a dawn, make you to shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of my hand. For to the angels God's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of a dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of my hand.
Friends, the Bible and the Christian Science textbook are our only preachers. We shall now read scriptural texts and their correlative passages from our denominational textbook. These comprise our sermon. The canonical writings, together with the word of our textbook, corroborating and explaining the Bible text in their spiritual import and application to all ages, past, present, and future, constitute a sermon undivorced from truth, uncontaminated and unfettered by human hypotheses, and divinely authorized. The lesson sermon for today begins on page 32 of the Christian Science Quarterly. The subject is mind. The golden text is from Psalms. The Lord hath been mindful of us. He will bless us. The responsive reading is from Deuteronomy and Philippians. The Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance.
He found him in a desert land and in the waste howling wilderness. He led him about. He instructed him. He kept him as the apple of his eye.
As an eagle stirreth up her nest, fluttereth over her young, spreadeth abroad her wings, taketh them, beareth them on her wings.
So the Lord alone did lead him, and there was no strange God with him.
Rejoice in the Lord alway, and again I say, rejoice.
Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplications with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God.
And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things.
The God of peace shall be with you. The following readings comprise our sermon.
The Bible, Psalms. In the multitude of my thoughts within me, thy comforts delight my soul. O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down-sitting and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. Thou compassest my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God! How great is the sum of them! If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. Jeremiah. I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end.
And correlative passages from the Christian Science textbook, Science and Health with Key to the Scriptures, by Mary Baker Eddy. All is infinite mind and its infinite manifestation. For God is all in all. Immortal and Divine Mind presents the idea of God, first, in light, second, in reflection, third, in spiritual and immortal forms of beauty and goodness. But this mind creates no element nor symbol of discord and decay. God creates neither erring thought, mortal life, mutable truth, nor variable love. Nothing can be novel to eternal mind, the author of all things, who from all eternity knoweth his own ideas. Deity was satisfied with his work. How could he be otherwise, since the spiritual creation was the outgrowth, the emanation of his infinite self-containment and immortal wisdom? Material sense does not unfold the facts of existence, but spiritual sense lifts human consciousness into eternal truth. A knowledge of the science of being develops the latent abilities and possibilities of man. It extends the atmosphere of thought, giving mortals access to broader and higher realms. It raises the thinker into his native air of insight and perspicacity.
Job. There is a spirit in man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding. Proverbs. Wisdom crieth without. She uttereth her voice in the streets. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. First Samuel. And the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli. And ere the lamp of God went out in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was, and Samuel was laid down to sleep, that the Lord called Samuel, and he answered, Here am I. And he ran unto Eli and said, Here am I, for thou callest me. And he said, I called not. Lie down again. And he went and lay down. And the Lord called yet again, Samuel. And Samuel arose and went to Eli and said, Here am I, for thou didst call me. And he answered, I called not, my son. Lie down again. And the Lord called Samuel again the third time. And he arose and went to Eli and said, Here am I, for thou didst call me. And Eli perceived that the Lord had called the child. Therefore Eli said unto Samuel, Go, lie down, and it shall be, if he call thee, that thou shalt say, Speak, Lord, for thy servant heareth. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. And the Lord came and stood and called, as at other times, Samuel, Samuel. Then Samuel answered, Speak, for thy servant heareth. And Samuel grew, and the Lord was with him, and did let none of his words fall to the ground. Isaiah. And all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children.
The children of God have but one mind. When it is learned that the spiritual sense, and not the material, conveys the impressions of mind to man, then being will be understood and found to be harmonious. Spirit imparts the understanding which uplifts consciousness and leads into all truth. Spiritual understanding unfolds mind, life, truth, and love, and demonstrates the divine sense, giving the spiritual proof of the universe in Christian Science. This understanding is not intellectual, is not the result of scholarly attainments. It is the reality of all things brought to light. Spirit, God, gathers unformed thoughts into their proper channels, and unfolds these thoughts, even as he opens the petals of a holy purpose, in order that the purpose may appear. Spiritual sense is a conscious, constant capacity to understand God.
Psalms. Hear my cry, O God. Attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee when my heart is overwhelmed. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. For he satisfieth the longing soul and filleth the hungry soul with goodness. They cry unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saveth them out of their distresses. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. He maketh the storm a calm, so that the waves thereof are still. Then are they glad because they be quiet, so he bringeth them unto their desired haven. Isaiah. The Lord of hosts has sworn, saying, Surely as I have thought, so shall it come to pass. And as I have purposed, so shall it stand. First Corinthians. For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints.
Upon this stage of existence goes on the dance of mortal mind. Mortal thoughts chase one another like snowflakes and drift to the ground. Stand porter at the door of thought. The divine mind is the soul of man and gives man dominion over all things. Through divine science, spirit, God, unites understanding to eternal harmony. The calm and exalted thought or spiritual apprehension is at peace. The calm, strong currents of true spirituality, the manifestations of which are health, purity, and self-immolation, must deepen human experience until the beliefs of material existence are seen to be a bald imposition, and sin, disease, and death give everlasting place to the scientific demonstration of divine spirit and to God's spiritual, perfect man.
The Gospel of Mark. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel." And straightway on the Sabbath day, he entered into the synagogue and taught. And there was in the synagogue a man with an unclean spirit. And he cried out, saying, "Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? I know thee who thou art, the Holy One of God." And Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Hold thy peace and come out of him." And when the unclean spirit had torn him and cried with a loud voice, he came out of him. And they were all amazed, insomuch that they questioned among themselves, saying, "What thing is this? What new doctrine is this? For with authority commandeth he even the unclean spirits, and they do obey him." And immediately his fame spread abroad throughout all the region round about Galilee. Second Timothy. God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Philippians. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Jesus of Nazareth was the most scientific man that ever trod the globe. He plunged beneath the material surface of things and found the spiritual cause. The real man, being linked by science to his maker, mortals need only turn from sin and lose sight of mortal selfhood to find Christ, the real man, and his relation to God, and to recognize the divine sonship. Christ, truth, was demonstrated through Jesus to prove the power of spirit over the flesh, to show that truth is made manifest by its effects upon the human mind and body, healing sickness and destroying sin. The basic error is mortal mind. The effect of this science is to stir the human mind to a change of base, on which it may yield to the harmony of the divine mind. When the mechanism of the human mind gives place to the divine mind, selfishness and sin, disease and death will lose their foothold. Physicians should not depart themselves as if mind were non-existent, nor take the ground that all causation is matter instead of mind. Ignorant that the human mind governs the body, its phenomena, the invalid may unwittingly add more fear to the mental reservoir already overflowing with that emotion. Instead of furnishing thought with fear, they should try to correct this turbulent element of mortal mind by the influence of divine love, which casteth out fear. When man is governed by God, the ever-present mind, who understands all things, man knows that with God, all things are possible. At the right time, explain to the sick the power which their beliefs exercise over their bodies. Give them divine and wholesome understanding with which to combat their erroneous sense, and so efface the images of sickness from mortal mind. It breaks the dream of disease to understand that sickness is formed by the human mind, not by matter, nor by the divine mind. Hold thought steadfastly to the enduring, the good, and the true, and you will bring these into your experience proportionably to their occupancy of your thoughts.
Philippians. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. The Gospel of Matthew. Take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. Even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Romans. To be spiritually minded is life and peace.
The perfect mind sends forth perfection, for God is mind. In divine science, man is sustained by God, the divine principle of being. The earth at God's command brings forth food for man's use. Knowing this, Jesus once said, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, presuming not on the prerogative of his Creator, but recognizing God, the Father and Mother of all, as able to feed and clothe man, as he doth the lilies. Taking less thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, less thought for your body, what ye shall put on, will do much more for the health of the rising generation then you dream. The divine mind which forms the bud and blossom will care for the human body, even as it clothes the lily. But let no mortal interfere with God's government by thrusting in the laws of erring human concepts. We cannot serve two masters, nor perceive divine science with the material senses. The scientific government of the body must be obtained through the divine mind. It is impossible to gain control over the body in any other way. Breaking away from the mutations of time and sense, you will neither lose the solid objects and ends of life, nor your own identity. Fixing your gaze on the reality supernal, you will rise to the spiritual consciousness of being, even as the bird which has burst from the egg and preens its wings for a skyward flight.
Psalms. The Lord hath been mindful of us. He will bless us. Romans. Now the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded one toward another, according to Christ Jesus, that ye may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Wherefore receive ye one another, as Christ also received us to the glory of God. Now the God of peace be with you all.
With one Father, even God, the whole family of man would be brethren, and with one mind, and that God or good, the brotherhood of man would consist of love and truth, and have unity of principle and spiritual power, which constitute divine science. Having no other gods, turning to no other but the one perfect mind to guide him, man is the likeness of God, pure and eternal, having that mind which was also in Christ.
Thank you.
Let us unite in singing hymn number 157. I shall read the last verse. Day by day, the understanding of our oneness shall increase, till among all men and nations, warfare shall forever cease. So God's children all shall dwell in joy and peace. Hymn number 157. Scientific Statement of Being from the Christian Science textbook. There is no life, truth, intelligence, nor substance in matter. All is infinite mind and its infinite manifestation, for God is all in all. Spirit is immortal truth. Matter is mortal error. Spirit is the real and eternal. Matter is the unreal and temporal. Spirit is God, and man is his image and likeness. Therefore, man is not material. He is spiritual.
And the correlative scripture from 1 John. Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure.
The Lord give thee understanding in all things. Amen. Thank you.